Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I joined this seminar today itself at in the second session when Mr. Shekhar Dutt was talking about COP21 and all that. So I was just wondering, this group is of technical experts already engrossed in solar power technology and developers and everyone. As a lender, what should I talk to you? I would like to give you lender's perspective, how I am looking at this segment as per se. When Mr. Shekhar Dutt, and it was also touched by Mr. Vipin Tyagi, who spoke at the end, sustainability aspect of solar power, for which every financial institution today is committed to. We have to look at sustainable future, sustainability of our resources. Coal is not going to last forever. So we have to look for alternative energy, and in that context, renewable energy is one source that is coming from nature, God gifted. We must use that. And bankers or lenders has to come forward to support that activity. Any lender, SBI being the largest bank, is there to support that, support this activity. Government of India has committed in Paris, they are going to install 175 gigawatt of renewable energy. Out of that, 100 gigawatt is coming from solar. And out of that 100 gigawatt, 40 gigawatts, they are aspiring to come from rooftop. Rooftop and solar energy looks same, but if you look as Ritu was telling, it's a different ballgame. Rooftop is not exactly the same as solar energy, solar power. It is something like we are talking about large corporates on the one hand and SME units on the other hand. Not the same. Activities are same, everyone is manufacturing, but SME and large corporates cannot be compared at one platform. Resilience capacity to sustain losses of the promoters or those who are installing rooftop is not same as large corporates. Anything going wrong, their losses will pinch more to them. They may not sustain it. And so the risk, element of risk or quality of risk in rooftop is totally different. Most of you here are associated with powers. Just I'm telling you to visualize your experience when you approached your bankers, what type of questions they asked and what sort of apprehensions they had. Naturally, everything has been discussed in the last 2 days. I have seen the program agenda. Technology aspects, doubts on longevity of solar panels, longevity of the units that is and that will use that power, those things, those risks are there. But still, we are trying to promote. I was just thinking, if I'm driving a car for the last 3 years, which is giving me 10 kilometers average per, 10 kilometers per liter, I'm getting an average, and someone comes and suggests me, why don't you buy a nano also, use it for 300 kilometers, save on petrol, it will return you the cost of nano in n number of years, 3 years, 5 years, 7 years. What will be my reaction? That is exactly the reaction I get from SMEs when we talk to them. Why don't you use solar panels in your factory site, working manufacturing site, and save on the energy costs? And the answer is, that is not my core activity. Why should I invest in solar rooftop, where I am to invest money which I could have used more profitably in my existing venture on which I am expert? Energy generation is not my core area. So if I am putting money in some activity which I don't know, I am relying on someone else, I am incurring additional risk, and I don't know whether the return or saving that I will make will give me more profit or profitability than what I am earning in the existing, my existing core activity. Why should I install? Then we say, okay, you don't install, but you can use third-party agencies who are developing solar power for you. They will give you cheaper power, and you can sustain. That may appeal to them. So, but from lender's perspective, I am more comfortable in financing CapEx model, because I know the unit, I know their profitability, I know their activity, I know the promoters. So I'm more confident on the promoters on which I am lending. So for a lender, CapEx model is always desirable model on which I would like to finance. But on the other side, my promoters may not be very keen to accept alternative way of generation of powers, and they are looking for third party activities where most of the developers come in. And they are installing solar powers at their rooftops, giving them power, using their rooftops, installing their equipments, and giving them power at a cost, cheaper cost. But there, what are the risks I am incurring? I don't know the third party first. Third party may be very effective, very financially strong, but do I get enough assurance that I am going to get assured cash flow over the next 10 or 15 years till my loan book runs? Any banker is interested in the assured cash flow for the period his loan book runs. From where I am getting the cash flow? Are the PPAs strong enough which guarantees me assured cash flow for the next few years till my loan is paid back? In today's scenario, till date, I have not seen any uniformity in PPAs which can assure me guaranteed cash flow. What could be the other alternative? Ideally, DISCOMs should have owned it, because DISCOMs are the ultimate users of your power. Whatever net metering policy or surplus that you are generating, it is going to DISCOMs, and customer who is paying to you is by saving money from the DISCOM. He is not going to the DISCOM and paying you. So ultimate ownership, ideally in ideal scenario, should have been for the DISCOM, to the DISCOMs, to own up this project and implement it in the country. But all of us know, there in today's scenario, possibly their capability to own up this type of or this size of project is maybe questionable, I would say. All DISCOMs may not be on the same footing or same strength that they support it. So from where I get the comfort? That is the question actually. Especially in the scenario where rates are coming down. One bid was at 6 rupees, then another was at 5 rupees, then 4 rupees, then 3 rupees, 297, 244, the ma'am was telling, 244. So from where this cost reduction is coming, and whether this cost reduction is going to raise some unknown risks in coming time, that I'm not very sure of. And this is such a new activity that those who are involved in this, they are also not masters in this game. They are also new and experimenting and relying on someone else. We were going by Bloomberg list of my suppliers, Trina Solar, First Solar, they are in the top 10. Top 10 list we are looking at, and we were going, okay, these suppliers are there, I am comfortable. Recently we were negotiating one financial line of credit with a German bank, and they were telling, no, these Bloomberg is not assessing, they are just giving you some experience. Are you assessing the quality of panels which are delivered to your borrowers on site? After delivery, is any agency available who can certify the quality of panels, and on that basis you are financing? Possibly no. When we are talking to some of the developers, they told they are doing the due diligence. Of course, every developer will do their due diligence before buying solar panels. But whether that due diligence is enough for sustaining the panels for the next 25 years, we need to, in fact, understand how it is going to happen. I visited one solar panel plant, manufacturing plant at US. And they showed their plant, and they were telling you, okay, they have got so many R&D and so many testing equipments which simulate all types of environmental vagaries, and their panel is sustaining for will sustain for all type of climatic adversaries for the next 10 years, 20 to 25 years. But I asked them, how are you guaranteeing it? And I think everyone is doing that. All panel suppliers, I am told, they give some more panels to you. In case something goes wrong, you can put this additional. Is it so? Developers, they will give you some certain percentage, 8%, 10% more panels to you, which you can keep as a spare. Anything going wrong, you can replace those panels. That is how the guarantee works. Otherwise, after 25 years, whether that company is in existence or not, whether what type of guarantees will be available to you, no one is sure of. So that is one way we are looking at. But one thing I would say, this is a very good beginning, and future lies in the solar. In fact, when some of my fellow colleagues questioned these things to me, I only responded, just 20 years back when mobile phone came, we were wondering whether we can afford 8 rupees per minute incoming and outgoing call rates. And today everyone knows, even the smallest, lowest and section of the society is having a mobile phone. So future is of renewable energy, whether wind energy, solar energy, and whoever is involved in it, they are definitely going to succeed. Maybe some changes, some market will balance everything. And we are very sure that banking industry will also, of course, there is competition, so they will come forward, and cheaper finance will be made available. From State Bank of India, we have tied up a line of credit from World Bank to reduce the cost of funds. And just let me tell you, for rooftop solar, our lending rate is today, we are just marking 0.5% over MCLR. Today it is 8.5%. That could be the lowest maybe, I don't know, unless it is a foreign currency funding. So I don't have any presentation. I just wanted to share my perspective as a lender. If you have any questions, I will be here to answer your questions gladly. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So.